Last year, the EU imported well over one-third of its natural gas from Russia to heat homes and provide electricity. What happens if Russia no longer delivers? How can we make Europe's energy supply secure? We will most certainly get through this winter, but we need to plan now for the next. There are at least five steps the EU needs to take to ensure it is well prepared for all scenarios. First, gas storage. Europe now needs to make sure that storage is filled to the maximum throughout spring and the summer. Not all countries have the same amount of storage, so we are talking at the minimum of coordination between member states, possibly an obligation for private suppliers to fill up their storage. Second, diversify energy supply. Some member states might need to prolong power plants originally scheduled for closure. Some might invest in nuclear, which remains controversial. There is little doubt, though, that we need liquefied natural gas, or LNG. This is gas which can be transported by specially designed ships from Qatar or the United States, but it's still a fossil fuel, which is bad for climate. Building the infrastructure is expensive, and finding long-term supply capacities complicated. That brings us to point number three, infrastructure. Only if electricity and gas can flow unhindered in the European market will we be able to buffer supply shocks. Energy has effectively become a European public good. The EU already invests into cross-border interconnectors and power lines, but much more needs to be done. Point number four is energy efficiency. The more energy we save, the less we need to import. The European Parliament is already negotiating new rules. This process likely needs to accelerate. The fifth point is renewable energy, biomass, wind, and solar. More than a fifth of Europe's energy already comes from renewables. Now, the European Parliament is debating more ambitious targets. Producing energy at home makes us less vulnerable abroad. And this goes hand in hand with the EU's climate goals. So what we're talking about in terms of policy is supplementing the Europe's climate policies with a real EU energy union to make both work together and leverage synergies. What's necessary for this to happen is political ambition and money.